Hey, welcome back to the channel. Today we have something really special for you. We're going to be looking at a vintage Conrad-Johnson Premier 10. Now this was a unit made back in the 90s, very unique unit, really overboard in its craftsmanship, and I think it has my vote as possibly being one of the best sounding preamplifiers ever built. And when I say the best, I mean the best. You know, a lot of times you'll think about maybe the Marantz Model 7, which, you know, the space capsule was unique in its time too, but I'm not too sure I would want to fly in it today. Or maybe some other stuff from the UK. But stay tuned. When you take a look at this, you're going to be really surprised. Here's a close-up of the detail on the knobs. See the laser cut grooves on these heavy aluminum knobs? The mute feature. Record, balance, which is electrically out of the circuit, and of course our on off and level. And then you have this beautiful thick aluminum faceplate. Although mine is not the perfect example. Fortunately, we have a few little scrapes here, which are unfortunate, but it happens on a piece of gear of this age. Now, we're not going to pay so much attention to the power supply, although that's pretty unique in itself. The power supply is kind of cool. It's basically all the capacitors in it are all polypropylene and polystyrene. There's only one electrolytic in the whole thing, which is for the filament supply. But what's really interesting is the gain stage. And what you have in the Premier 10, and I really consider this American Shindo, it's really cool. It's a very unique design. You have your input that comes in, as you can see there, and then you go through a 23-position switched ladder network. Basically, it's a handmade mechanical switched resistor ladder network for the volume control. And then you go into, so there's basically at any time, there's only two resistors in the signal path, which is really interesting. That's very, very, very straightforward, very unique. No digital potentiometers, nor no carbon tracking pots, just basically a couple resistors are being utilized as your volume control in this. And then you come in here, and then you have your input resistor, your grid stopper, which is basically a 1K resistor. You see that. And it goes into the first gain stage, which is a 6GK, 6GK5, right? A 6GK5 triode tube. And then it has a cathode follower, another 6GK5. And then it comes out and you go into a couple parallel 2.2 microfarad polystyrene capacitors. And then a 47.5 R resistor, which is a film and foil, Vishay foil, bulk foil resistor. And actually all these resistors, both the grid stopper, the input resistor, and the plate resistor, and the output resistor are all Vishay foil resistors, which is fantastic. And you notice there's no feedback. No feedback. I mean, this is how it's done. Triode gain stage with no feedback. So what we're going to do for a couple changes, we're going to do some resistor upgrade that I forgot about, is that, and maybe a few of you might have caught on to this, that there is one drawback to the circuit, and it's the fact that it actually inverts phase. And I think maybe that's been the one drawback to the unit overall. I can imagine over the years, people probably bought these, you know, traded these, you know, online or pick them up used or on Audiogon or wherever. And there's really not a lot of information unless you have the owner's manual. I think it does mention in the owner's manual that the unit doesn't invert phase. But I can just imagine, you know, somebody shelling out, you know, several thousand dollars for this unit, bringing it home, maybe dropping in some new tubes, listening to it and going, you know, something just doesn't quite sound right. And because they never went, nobody ever told them it actually inverts phase. And it's easily fixed. All you have to do is just switch the polarity of your speaker cables and you're right back to you know, back to good again. But I can see that if somebody didn't know, you know, if somebody didn't know, I could see this would go through a half a dozen people, half a dozen audiophiles, people playing it in their system and comparing it to other gear, and just not realizing that the circuit inverts phase, and it's easily addressed by just flipping the polarity on your speaker cables, making everything good again. But you do have to keep that in mind when using this unit. You know, if you drop it in and you don't make that end correction at your speaker cable to get everything back in phase again, it's not going to sound quite right. So anyways, you know, just keep that in mind. And here in this, we've highlighted the resistors that we're going to change again. We're going to do the AudioNote silver tantalum here for the grid stopper, the input resistor. And then the plate resistor is going to be the AMRG right there. And then here's your output resistor, the 47.5R, and the two little capacitors that are in parallel there. But what a wonderful circuit. So if you ever do get one of these, remember to correct your phase at your speaker cables. All right. Now you could do this a little differently. You know, somebody, you know, you might do that grid resistor. You might do that as a carbon film and do the AudioNote tantalum, you know, silver tantalum as the plate resistor. You could switch it around like that, but I wanted to warm it up. I mean, this is already an extremely transparent, very, very transparent signal. I didn't want to make it too clinical, too solid state sounding. So that's why we went with the carbon film on the plate. Incredible results. So just kind of wanted to see what an interesting circuit this is. It's very unique. And you don't see this really done very much anymore. But this works really well with, you know, pairing this up with another single-ended triode amplifier or zero feedback solid-state amp like the Pass LF3 or Pass LF5 or any of the newer Pass amps would work really well with this. Okay, really cool. So now we'll go and we'll take a look inside the actual huge unit. I mean, these things are big. Weighs about 30 pounds. And if you can tell, it's, you know, it's almost the size, it's bigger, it's as big as a record player. I mean, it's huge. You compare this to the Pass 3, I mean, the Pass 3 looks compact. The Pass Labs LF3 amplifier looks compact compared to the size of the preamp. It's a big unit. It's a big unit. And the whole gain stage is floating on a separate tray that is suspended on polymer dampeners to reduce suspension. You can see how that moves a little bit. It's suspended on polymer dampeners to remove any to isolate it from additional vibration. You got a beautiful transformer that's also additionally separated or shielded from the rest of the analog supply. Just beautifully thought out, and beautifully executed. The Conrad-Johnson Premier 10. You don't see these around very much anymore, and just really exciting. I really, you know, just really, when you match this up, you have a very simple gain stage with zero feedback, and you match this up with it like a nice single-ended tube amplifier or a single-ended zero feedback solid-state amplifier like a Pass Labs. Just incredible sound, incredible sound. The clarity and the tonal decay that you get is just beyond anything you've heard before. It's very musical. And then over here, we have your power supply, which is all polypropylene, no electrolytics. And there is a single electrolytic right here, which is the filament supply. And as you can see, we've replaced that with a Mundorf, a very high quality Mundorf unit for the filament supply. So that's brand new. That'll be good for a long time. And so our resistor upgrades, what we've done is for the cathode, we've replaced the cathode resistors with these AMRGs. You can see there's two of them. They're paralleled for the right and left channel to get the correct value that we needed. And those are the 2-watt big ones. And then the input resistors have been replaced with the 2-watt AudioNote silver tantalums, and those are outrageously expensive, okay? They're about $50 a resistor, maybe more now. So they're very expensive, very transparent, Very, very nice resistor. So basically you come through, you know, the volume control, the step ladder attenuator, and you go through these two silver tantalums and then right into the gain stage. And then you have the cathode follower right there, and zero feedback circuit, absolutely no feedback. It's beautiful. And then it goes through these output capacitors, which I believe are, these two and these two are the output capacitors. And you got plenty of room. I mean, the next step, if you wanted to get exhaustive, you know, these could easily be replaced with some nice Jupiter copper films. I mean, you got plenty of space. These are only about 2 UF, and they're running in parallel for the right channel and left channel, or vice versa, right channel and left channel, but they're in parallel. And so you got a total of roughly 4 UF per channel. Four for the left and four for the right, right? So you got plenty of room to upgrade those caps. And these are a nice polystyrene, but, you know, they're pretty old. But you could definitely have room to upgrade those to some nice copper foils if you wanted to. And then after the caps, you're going through these two 47R resistors, okay? And as you can see, all these resistors are the Vacher metal film, and we've replaced the two output resistors with some nice 2-watt audio note tantalums, right? Just to warm it up a little bit and give it a lot, some nice dynamics. Those are beautiful. So really some very simple resistor upgrades. Basically the input resistors are the, silver tantalums. And then we have some, carbon film, for the cathode resistors, which make it nice and dynamic, musical. And then we have the two output resistors of audio note tantalums. So really nice. Just a few simple upgrades. We've kept all these old resistors. They could always be reversed back to OEM if you wanted to, though I have no idea why somebody would, because it just sounds incredible. Definitely, I believe, one of the best sounding preamps that have ever been made. And I like to jokingly say it's the preamp that everyone forgot about. All right, so in the back here, this is really cool. This is a 23-position switched resistor ladder network for the volume control. This is the volume control. And you see how when I move the volume control in the front, it switches. It's a dual mono construction, and it switches through. So there's only, at one time, there's only ever two pairs of resistors in the signal path. This is incredible. You have no idea how expensive this would be to have somebody build this by hand. And this is all hand-built. And these are all mil-spec Dale RN60 resistors, a whole bunch of them. You can see them going all the way down all those rows, two rows, one for the left and one for the right channel, right? And then it's activated by this metal bar that goes through the length of the unit underneath the circuit board all the way to the volume control in the front, right? Just incredible construction, right? This is just first class, handmade all the way. You just don't see this in today's designs unless you're looking at something really, really super high end. And again, you have, looks to be silver wire going from the circuit board. I mean, the only thing better than this is such a high quality circuit board. The only thing better than this would be point-to-point wiring, right? Which is extremely expensive. And here's your balance control. Now, these switches are all silver-plated switches. And as I recall, I saw the specs on these. They were used in a bunch of different gear in the 90s. But I remember they were good for some incredible amount of activations. Like, I don't know, like 10 million activations or something like that was the useful life or something. It's just a crazy amount. And, you know, worst case, they can all be disassembled and cleaned. I mean, these ones are nice and solid. But, you know, this is something that's going to last multiple lifetimes. It's really heirloom type construction in here. You don't have any SMDBS, any surface mount resistor stuff that, you know, is going to be a pain in the future. It's very, very high quality and excellent sound quality. Only two pairs of resistors are ever in the circuit at any one time. Amazing.
All right, let's take a little listen and see what this thing will do.
Coisa mais linda, mais cheia de graça, ela menina que vem, que passa, um doce balanço, caminho do mar. Moça do corpo dourado, do sol de Ipanema, o seu balançado é mais que um poema, é a coisa mais linda que eu já vi passar. Ah, estou tão sozinho. Ah, por que tudo é tão triste? Ah, beleza que existe. Ah, beleza que não é só minha, que também passa sozinha. Se ela soubesse que quando ela passa, o mundo sorrindo se enche de graça e fica mais lindo por causa do amor.
Thanks for watching. More to come.